morning. It's been a minute. I'm back from my vacation from Zimbabwe and I just woke up and I have a cool new hairstyle and I missed you guys and I'm ready to get back to recording. So anyways, I was supposed to go to the club on Monday. Today's Wednesday, which I will go in today, and then I'll go in Saturday as well. So maybe like two videos this week, but yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and get ready. Gotta wax the underarms and my legs, and then we'll be ready to go. I'm a little nervous going back. Alrighty, y'all. So I'm on my way to the club, and today's the 30th. It is a Wednesday. And not gonna lie, I'm really tired. I don't know. I feel like I've just still been recovering from jet lag from my trip to Zimbabwe, and I am just like my schedule's been like all over the place pretty much. So I'm still trying to fix it. I've been getting like 5 hours of sleep every night. It really sucks. I don't know. But hopefully like I'll be able to get on a better sleep schedule, because you know you do need energy to be doing this shit, and it's never fun to go into a job like this and you're already fucking tired. But yeah, I'm gonna try to fix my schedule. Anyways, I will probably record. I'm gonna try to record a little more in the club. I feel like I want to get more of like the club environment, and I keep saying I'm gonna get like a little sweep through shot of the club, and I never do it because I get there and I'm like so focused. But yeah, I need to learn to multitask better. But I'll try to get more footage, and maybe I'll do like more check-ins while I'm at the club and not just like before and after. So yeah, see y'all when I'm there. Hasn't really picked up, but hopefully it does. There's like 5 people in here, but we're starting to make a little something, so hopefully it picks up. But yeah, just vibing. Just got off stage and it is about 2:23, so hopefully it starts picking up more. Especially because it was the first night that I've been back since my vacation, and I pushed myself like quite a bit. I actually did some like pull tricks and stuff, so I tried a lot of new things, practiced a lot, and I worked 11 to 9. So yeah. Anyways, my room is a mess. It's gonna get cleaned today, but yeah, I didn't even sleep for that long, not as long as I wanted to really like let my body recover or whatever, but I have a class at 11, another at 12:30, and another at 2:15, so yes, we do have to go to campus today. I have classes Tuesday and Thursday, so let me do a money count, Let me freaking clean up my room. Maybe play a little bit of Overwatch before I go to class. And, yeah. Hey, bitch! Okay, where do I usually set this thing? Right here. There we go. Alright, here's our bag from last night. Good shit. Okay. Just count just money, but also like I have tea. So if your cup is empty, good. If it's not empty, empty it and prepare to be filled. LOL. Okay, actually, wait, I need a better angle for this because. So. Freaking. Last night was wild, right? It was a Wednesday. I did a day shift and then I asked to stay for 2 additional hours. So, as I mentioned before, I did an 11 to 9. And. Tell me why. There's this one old guy, he's a regular, he's like really fucking old, we're just gonna call him Jay. He's pretty much in that club almost every fucking day, and he never tips, literally never tips any of the girls. He like gets drinks and just likes to watch girls dance. He's always trying to like do the most though. He's the guy to try and, like, get extras and all that shit, and, like, he just doesn't pay anybody, like, what's that about? So, anyways, I remember him, even though I've been gone for 2 weeks, because he was there the first day that I ever worked at the club, and I remember him because he talked to one of the other dancers that was kind of, like, helping me throughout the day. And she came up to me and she was like, yeah, don't bother with him, like, he doesn't tip anybody, like, literally wasted my effing time. And I was like, okay, you know, like, yeah, thanks for letting me know. Some of these I already counted when I was at work. I think these two I already counted. Anyway, this dude will literally go up to other customers as well. Like, he's not just in there trying to, like, talk to the dancers. He literally will go up to other customers and try to, like, talk to those girls and shit. And it's like, are you kidding me? Who the fuck does that? That's so awkward. And he'll, like, try to sit at people's tables and stuff and, like, talk to them. And it's just really weird. He is like trying to be buddy-buddy with everybody in that club, and it's really, really awkward. And then he'll go up to the girls and say like disgusting things to them. Like not rude things, but like really like sexual things, like, you know, what he wants to do to them and all that, you know? And he tries to like I said, do the most, right? So as long as he's been going there, he should know you're not allowed to be like touching the girls like that. He will try it. He will fucking try it. And he went up to one of my friends, one of the fucking dancers, and I just remember her face being like, she looked so shocked. And so I asked her later when the guy like walked away for a second and she finally got off stage. I was like, bruh, what did he say to you? Your face was like, she was like, oh, this is gonna need a lot of filtering. She was like, oh, he was telling me how he wants to put his tongue in my punani and how he wants to like F me so bad and how he likes a legs and butt kind of girl and what he would do to me and all this other stuff. And What else did he say to her? He told her that he wanted to, like, sprinkle cocaine on her punani and lick it. I was like, what the actual F? Like, oh my god. Just vulgar things. Some other stuff I really just don't care to repeat, but he also came up to me during my stage set and was like, oh, you and your friend over there, you're just such sexy girls, you know, you're my kind of girls, leg and butt, da 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 da. And just, again, very similar stuff, just telling me, like, all this stuff that he wanted to do to me, how he wanted me to, like, sit on his face and all this stuff, and just vulgar things that I, again, don't really care to repeat, but it was just like, wow, wow, I'm amazed. You're standing here, and you're talking to me, and you're telling me all this stuff, but what I'm not seeing, and it was just like, wow. Yeah, no, F off, please. I'm never talking to him again. He found us later and tells us that he's leaving. And he's like, oh, I just wanted to come say bye. I was trying to get you and your friend's attention over at the VIP. I was hoping y'all would come sit with me. And we were just like, oh, yeah, sorry. Like, yeah, nah, shit, we're not coming over to you. You're not tipping us. Like, but you want to talk to us like that and try to touch us in really inappropriate ways that are pushing the boundaries, you know? Like, no, of course we're not going to go over there. Waste our time. So, anyways, he's like, yeah, I'm leaving. I'm going away for like a month. I'm going on a trip to around, he's like, I'm going to like 15 different states or something like that, doing a bunch of stuff with his other rich buddies. We were like, oh yeah, that's crazy, yeah, you're really doing it all, you know, have a great time, yeah. We'll see you when you're back, like, take lots of pictures, da da da, you know. Faking it till you make it, smiling, being nice, whatever, even though we're like, vomiting in our mouths. So yeah, he tells us bye. But the dude comes back, like, an hour and a half later. And so, we're just like, what? And he comes up to me during my stage set again, and he's like, what does he say? What did he say? He's like, oh, hold up. Hello. Yeah, during my stage set, and he comes up and he's like, yeah, I'm back. And we're like, okay, like, why though? And he's like, oh yeah, I went home and I got freshened up. He's like, took a shower, I changed my fit and all this other stuff. I was like, wow, cool. So what, were you like dirty as fuck before? I don't understand. Anyways, and then he proceeds to like walk around the club. I'm pretty sure he brought cocaine with him when he came back, because one of the girls that I was talking to that night, my dancer friend, she was the one who was like, yeah, he has like cocaine with him, and you know, she does that, whatever, her business. I'm like, oh, okay, didn't know that about you, but you know, I don't judge. I literally do not care. It's your fucking life. And she was like, yeah, I'm gonna get some from him. And I was like, okay. So she goes to him and they have their little exchange of druggy wuggies. And they both end up going to like the different bathrooms or whatever to like, and yeah. That was kind of that. And then the dude would, again, walk around talking to literally anybody that he could. Just really, really touchy. Very, very touchy. And at one point, when I was sitting with him and his friend in the VIP section, which again, I only went over there once his friend showed up, because I was like, okay, maybe his friend will actually tip and like spend some money. Never really did. He gave me like $5. Before I left, I sat there for like freaking 40 minutes with them,
because he was like, oh, you know, at some point in our conversation, he was telling me like how if he really likes a girl or whatever, he usually tips them a couple hundred. So of course I'm going to stay and I'm going to try to get your couple hundred. And he would go on and on about like how nice I was and how like great of a listener I was. And like he enjoyed our conversation and I was like, bet, please give me them hundreds. And like, yeah, no, he tipped me fucking $5. I was like low-key pissed. I was like, wow, literally could have been talking to anybody else, but you know, it happens. What can you do? Whatever. I should have better judgment next time, I guess. But yeah, it was just like, okay, so your friend's not here to really tip either, whatever. But yeah, it was just wild. He is one customer who really just... Security needs to watch him because I low-key feel like something's gonna happen at some point with that customer. Cause he's problematic as fuck. He's really problematic. Big bills. We got a 20, a 10, and a 5, and all of these are ones. Any other tea besides this wild old man who I'm literally going to avoid like the plague? It was a good night. I saw a lot of familiar dancer faces and they remembered me and I was like, oh sweet, yeah. We had a lot of fun. It's pretty dead during day shift, not gonna lie. It doesn't pick up until like 3 or 4 and then it gets dead again and then it doesn't pick up until like 8. So that's why I decided to stay a little longer because it was just a little too dead for what I was hoping to make that night. And definitely shouldn't have pushed myself so much. I like did a lot that night. And woke up just feeling like death this morning. But it was a good night. I had fun. Me and the girls, you know, when there's nobody in the club, we try to encourage customers to tip, so we literally go to each other's stages and like hype each other up and stuff, and usually it gets the guys to at least sit at the stage and tip however much they can. But yeah, people weren't tipping like crazy that night. There was maybe 2 customers that came in that really liked me and they tipped me pretty well. A lot of people liked my hair. Like, where I live, it's very kind of white central. And I don't know, I feel like seeing a black girl with like hair like mine when it's in, you know, like braids and they're a wild color and I have beads, they're like they've never seen that before, you know, it's really funny. And they're just like, your hair is amazing, and they just love it. And it looks really cool when I'm on the pole and I'm spinning and my hair is long as frick and it's flowing behind me. It's so cool. I feel cool. But yeah, that's kind of how my night went. I had my first lap dance. Yay me! Was it awkward? Absolutely. The guy was really cool. Very business kind of guy, he came in with the whole suit fit and all that, and he came directly over to me, which is cool, I guess. Yeah, he was nice. I was dancing, he tipped me right away, and then I went over, you know, asked what his name was, build that rapport, whatever, and offered a dance, and he was like, yeah, how much a song? And I was like, yeah, it's 35 a song. You know, it happens over there, and yeah, just pretty much we go until you don't feel like doing any more dances, you know. Obviously I didn't word it like that, but that's how I explained it. And he was like, yeah, let's do that, I would love a dance from you, da-da-da-da-da. So we did that. He wasn't staying that long, which he really didn't stay that long, so it's not like he was like lying to me and ended up like staying long and just talking to like other dancers and stuff. Like, he had a drink, tipped a couple girls, tipped me, enjoyed his time, and then got the lap dance, maybe had another drink and then left. Like, he was there for like half an hour. But yeah, he was cool and he was my first lap dance. So it's not my favorite spot in the club, just because the chairs, they really are so close to each other, and they have like the clear plexiglass whatever because like COVID, right? But it's really awkward because the chairs are only so big, it doesn't even really allow the customer room to fully like spread their legs so you can have room to step around them and do stuff. You can't put your knee on the chair anywhere to really like do something more exciting. You just kind of have to like dance in front of them because it's such a small space. And then maybe you can like use their knees to hold you up while you do like a little twirl. And maybe that's like about it. There's really not room for you to be like leaning over the customer and just like giving like a really good lap dance. It's very like, I'm gonna dance in front of you and I can't really dance like over you. So it was tough, especially being in heels. I know like some clubs, you can like take your heels off during a dance. Some of them want you to, some people prefer you to. But for me, it was like, nah, I'll just keep it on. I knew he wasn't staying long, so I was like, why go through the trouble? He's probably not gonna do like a long dance, which he didn't. It was literally just the one song because he wasn't staying long. But it was like, okay, yeah, good enough practice for me. Like, dang. But it was nice. It was nice. And I feel like I had a pretty good night overall. Yeah, that's about it. Let's sort this into stacks of 20, and then I'll come back and tell you how much I made for the night. Alrighty, here we go. This is last night's money. Again, stacks of 20. This is a stack of 12. This one's a bit teeny just because it has a 10, a 5, and 5 ones, but here we go. We've got 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 20, 40, 60, so that's 160, 172. So we made 172, which is okay. It's okay. It was a really slow day, so this is understandable, but yeah, hopefully I can break 200 at some point. At some point being like Saturday. I really want to do really well and try to like push further and further goals, but you know, I'm grateful for it. I'm grateful for it because it's still more money than I had, and it's still more money than I'd be making at my retail job. So it's just nice to know that like I'm still averaging over 150. And yeah. Now, I gotta get ready for class. My econ lecture is online though, so I'm not going anywhere, but I do have to get ready really quickly after to walk to campus and go to my other two in-person classes. Yeah, it's really fun. I don't have the energy, and if I didn't have to go, I wouldn't, but I really shouldn't, like, just not go to my classes. I already missed last week because I was still on vacation. And you know, it's catch-up week, so I need to get over myself. It's gonna be tough, and I knew what I was getting myself into going on a trip for that long. So the work has to be done. I have a major assignment due Sunday, so I do need to start working on it today, tomorrow, and Sunday as well. I have until midnight then, so a lot to do, no energy to do it, but college for you. Okay, y'all. So I actually made 192. I forgot to mention that I took DJ 10 because he was playing back to back bangers, dude. And I was like, oh yeah, I like him. And he helped me out too. Like, one of the girls wasn't feeling well. She left early and I had to go on stage like shortly after I just did my stage set. And he was like, I'm so sorry for that, you're the only one that's like kind of like free right now, that I could spot right away. And he was like, yeah, sorry, I saw you first, and would you mind like running up on stage? And I was like, yeah, no, it's not a problem. So he made like a special announcement for me. He was like, oh,
helping me out, you know? And that was great. That was great. He was an awesome DJ. I need him every time that I work. So yeah, I tipped him 10. I tipped valet 5. And then I have to pay 5 to the club for every lap dance. So yeah, 172 plus my tip out. I made 192 that night in total. But take home 172. And I also just realized this is the biggest night that I've had. Yeah, this is the most that I've made in a night. And that's really cool. Forgot about that. Good morning.
I forgot to put my hair up last night. I was so tired. I just went to sleep, man. Not sore anymore, but 2 days has honestly felt like only one day passed by. I'm like, not ready to go back yet, but we're gonna go to the club again. It's been a little tough still catching up with school and like finding the energy to edit, so I've decided to just combine my Wednesday shift with today's shift and just post one video until I feel like I can be more consistent with editing. But yeah, it might be another couple days until I upload it. I do have a big assignment due Sunday. If I can be productive between today and tomorrow though, maybe it'll be posted in time. But anyways, let's hurry up and get ready. I do need to grab gas before heading to work today, and I'm already like 20 minutes into my routine and I haven't done anything for the morning. I'm a little bit tired, so let's up the urgency, you know? Okay.
Almost 4. I am taking a little snack break. I feel like I didn't really make that much today, but we'll see when I do my money count. I just feel like I definitely like didn't make as much as I would have hoped for a freaking Saturday, but then again, I did day shift. Like, night shift is gonna be more poppin', but yeah, it's just really tough, you know? I did feel like I offered dances to a lot of people. I feel like I'm just trying to like do things right, do things better, and you know, it's not me. It's not me, it's the customers. They have their preferences, you know, and they either like what they see or they don't, and they either want dances or they don't, but I'm not gonna let that be a reflection of me or what I'm doing, because I know, like, I'm really trying, so, yeah. We'll just keep it going. The people that like me, the people that want to tip, they're gonna tip. It's definitely one of those things that is in my control, but also out of my control at the same time. It's tough, but I'm gonna keep on working. I just think my energy has been a little low this week and I haven't been on top of my game as much. I'm just a little bored and exhausted with school. Kind of an excuse, not really an excuse,
But yeah, y'all get it. Anyways, I'm really fucking hungry. I just want to get home so I can stop somewhere and get food. And I have some, like, homework assignments to do. Don't want to do them. Have to. It is what it is. But yeah! And story time. I have more story time. I have more tea. Thought your cup was full. Not even. So yeah, let me get out of my apparently goth beach getup. I meant to take this off before I left. I forgot I had it on. Work is over. We can stop being fucking S-tier waifu with our freaking choker from Hot Topic. Anyways, let me cut this off so I can get on the road and get going. Alright, I'll see y'all when I'm home and done eating and everything else that I gotta do. Anyway, bye!
I'm the only one popping my pussy right now.
Okay. Domino's from freaking yesterday that I finished and just didn't throw away. The room needs cleaning. Tidying, if you will. Oh my god, guys! Look at my newest keychain. Isn't it cute? It's so cute. It's a little fish. Anyways, while I have energy to do it, let's do this money count. Yeah, so like I said before, this thing is barely full. Like, I don't think tonight was a good night, which, you know, again, proving wrong the stereotype that... Saturdays are like guaranteed money. That's a lie, y'all. That's a lie. Ain't nothing guaranteed. You have just as much opportunity of doing really well during an early day shift as somebody who works like only weekend night shifts, you know? Okay. This is tonight's moolah. I kind of sorted through it during my shift. So I have 3 stacks of 20. I have some big bills. I have a 20, a 5, there's a 10. This is 1, 2. Oh shit, that's another stack of 20s. Hold on, it's another 20. Wait a second, y'all. Wait a second. Tonight might have been a good night. Hold on. Money is deceiving, man. I can't ever tell how much I freaking make. Let's count this. I like that my roommates, are literally just watching like cute cartoons. They have no idea what I do. They're literally, you could probably hear it. I think they're watching like an anime or something. While I'm like over here counting my fucking money from being a stripper. Okay, so we got 220s. There you go. Yep, they're facing the same way. Okay. 220s, a 10, and this is a 5. Let's count how many ones this is. Okay, here we go. All right. So again, stacks of 20. This is tonight's money. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's 100. 120. Wait, yeah, this is a stack. This is a stack. Okay, yeah, this is a stack of 20 as well. So this is 100. 20, 40, and this is a stack of 6. So, 146.
That's not bad, actually. I really thought I didn't do well, but it's because I had bigger bills and not as many like ones. Money's so deceiving, y'all. That's not how I actually laugh, by the way. It's more like... Nah, it's not like that either. Anyways, we made 146 tonight. Saturday day shift. Not terrible. I worked a 12 to 7. So, I am pleased. Not as much as, when did I work last? Wednesday? Yeah, not as much as Wednesday, but you know, that's okay. It's a Saturday. Like, most of the people were showing up for evening shift, not fucking the daytime. So, it was okay. And I didn't have to pay house fees because I was one of the first girls who showed up. So, good night.
And now I'm gonna go wash my dirty ass hands from handling this money, but I'm gonna pile it, sort it, finish touching it and all that. I need to go to CVS. Yep. Or maybe Walmart. I think I might go to CVS actually. I need to get a money order so I can actually deposit this money into my online bank. You know, so I can like go ahead and start paying off college debt. That's what this is for. So as much as I'd like to put it towards things like rent and yada yada yada, that's what my retail job is for. So yeah, but it still helps, like it still helps, but this is strictly for paying off college debt. So I'm trying not to spend it on like fast food and a bunch of like other pointless shit. It's either like I'm using the money that I make to like pay my house fees or gas money or invest in outfits, nail supplies, anything I need for this job, that's what this is for, outside of college debt. But it's for college debt, so yeah. Definitely though, because I'm only working 2 days at my retail job now, I will have to use some of it for paying my rent. And so that's why I need to go ahead and make that money order. I don't want to keep pulling from my savings. But, you know, you start slow. I'm spending this money towards necessities, and I can't quite spend it on luxuries just yet, but we're gonna reach that point. I'm really hoping that I can break 200. I got so close on Wednesday, but I'm really hoping that I can break 200. One of these day shifts, it's gonna happen. I'm gonna find a customer that is just, like, ballin' on me specifically, and it'll be a really good day, evening, whatever. But yeah, for now, I just need to get off my butt while I have energy, do all the little to-do things that I need, so that I can go ahead and get started on my stupid freaking homework. And once that's done, my week is looking easy. I just gotta get through this weekend. The dread of tomorrow's assignment. I really am dreading this assignment, but anyways. We got a lot to do tonight, a lot of little to-do things, but they're all time-consuming, so gotta get to it. But anyways, that pretty much concludes this video. Thanks so much for watching. Really, really appreciate all of you that are, like, liking and subscribing and commenting. I read every single comment, of course, because it's, like, a few. Like, it's manageable, you know? And I always try to respond, you know, something sweet or like, you know, just give a genuine response because I do appreciate y'all taking the time to comment. So, yeah, let me know your thoughts on, I don't know, my progress, I guess. I don't know. Let's talk about literally anything. I just want to interact with people. So, yeah, let's do that. Let's do that. Let's chit chat. Anyways, thanks again for watching, and I'll see y'all in my next vid, which will probably be posted on Tuesday, if I'm productive with uploading the video, because I work Monday. So we'll see. Okay, yeah, bye.